It was announced this week that the Chicago Bears Super Bowl Shuffle dance video has earned almost $600,000 to date, with 10% of the gross sales earmarked for charity. 600 G's. Can you believe this thing made $600,000? You know, I don't think I've seen choreography that stiff since the Lee Harvey Oswald prison transfer. Well, here again to steer a course through the rocky shoals of international politics is our senior correspondent, A. Whitney Brown, with the big picture. Whitney.
Thank you, Dennis.
Run with it.
Well, when you look at the big picture this week, one thing stands out. A wave of patriotism has gripped this nation like a pit bull on a pork roast. Yes, we're all celebrating America's greatest military triumph since the invasion of Grenada, the glorious Gulf of Sidra maneuvers. Now, I'll admit, in the case of Grenada, it didn't take a whole lot of military strategy to knock over a fruit stand with two aircraft carriers. But crossing an imaginary line, now there's something to stand up and crow about. Of course, the great thing about attacking Libya, besides the fact that they always deserve it, is that you don't have to worry about anybody leaping to their defense. Of course, now in retaliation, Gaddafi's threatened to poke out the eyes of the American imperialist monster. All I can say to that, Muammar, is, ooh, I'm shaking. Of course, the Europeans have a different attitude. Right now, they're as nervous as a Christian Scientist with a severed artery. But let's put this into the big picture. Wasn't it Italy that opened the garden gates for Abu Nidal? The next time some sun-crazed Shiite martyr blasts a few Italians across the piazza, maybe they'll draw up a new extradition treaty. As for France, I think it's worth mentioning those gunboats we sank to 600 feet in the Gulf of Sidra were manufactured by our good friends the French, as was, incidentally, that nuclear reactor in Iraq the Israelis had to take the time out of their busy lunch hour to blow off the map a few years ago. Proving that a French pimp will sell anything to anybody. Probably the biggest lesson in this glorious military victory is that the French make pretty chintzy military equipment. Next time we need an ego boost, maybe we should send the Enterprise steaming up the Seine. See if our Gallic friends want to come out and play. But then again, maybe we should leave the poor French alone. It's not really nice to pick on a country that arguably came out on the losing side in a war with Greenpeace. I guess our friends in Europe are going to have to learn for themselves that if you play with firecrackers, your fingers are going to get blown off. And that, my friends, is the big picture.
Thank you, guys. We won't do it. Too late.
Okay, thank you. Thank you, Whitney. Thank you. And you know, it in fact was a French pimp that sold me to this show. A group of militarized pigeons today overthrew the government of Ecuador in a major political coup. And that, in fact, is the news, folks. I am out of here. Good night, ladies and gentlemen.